I'm not bad. I'm looking forward to a bit of a drink and an eat and see.
Nothing to do with the beauty. It's all about the champagne.
Like, girls all love a bit of beauty, don't we? We all use it.
Exactly. How important is an event like this for you? Do you enjoy your beauty regime?
To be honest, I'm really bad. I'm just, whatever's in the cupboard, I slap on.
So you're not one of these people. I know MTV has just launched a show, Beauty School Dropout. It's how much money they spend on beauty products. Are you not one of these people?
I'm not one of those people, but as I'm getting older now, so what, mid-30s, I should probably be taking a bit more care, so I need to pay attention.
Whatever you're doing is working for you, so I wouldn't change. Now, let's talk about the big reunion, a very exciting time for you.
Big reunion's been an absolute whirlwind. It's been amazing. We've got the tour coming up in December as well, so I can't wait.
So what was the highlight of the whole show for you?
The initial getting together and just kind of going through everything that happened and catching up with all these people we'd been on tour with for years and years, so long ago. And then the O2. So performing at the O2, 20,000 people was ridiculous.
Why was it now the right time to reunite? And did it go as you expected, or better or worse, God forbid?
It was all really surprising. I think we all initially did it think it was going to be a one-off gig, and then the public was so warm towards everything, and it turned into this massive arena tour, and we were all completely gobsmacked, if I'm honest. I didn't expect it to be that big at all.
Any surprises along the way, or did it all just come straight back like you hoped?
The biggest surprise for me, there's so many egos, 26 people on a tour bus, and not a single fight. Everyone just got on and were like one big happy big reunion family, which is really cheesy, but actually true.
No divas in the group then.
No. Well, maybe one. Maybe in my own band there's a couple of divas.
And you mentioned the tour's coming up. Tell us a little bit more about that. What can we expect to see?
We're doing a Christmas tour, so through December, and there's a Christmas single out for charity as well for Tech Santa. So we're going to be busy the next couple of months.
And are we going to be seeing new material come out? Are you getting back in the studio soon?
Yeah, the girls and I have been in the studio writing and recording, so hopefully by the end of the year we'll have something out.
Fans can be getting very excited.
Yes, keep getting Twitter messages going, when's the music coming?
So, you know, when you're working in the studio together, is there someone out there right now on the music scene that you'd like to work with?
There are so many people. My favourite person right now is Ed Sheeran. It's taken me so long to get that album, but now I have it. It's on loop constantly. I think he's amazing.
You are working with Ed Sheeran, or you want to work with Ed Sheeran?
No, I would love to work with Ed Sheeran. Yes, we are.
That is big news. Let's talk about that.
That would be amazing.
Obviously, from the time when you were with Honeys and now you're back again, how has the music industry changed?
The main difference for me is that kind of instant media reaction, like Twitter and Facebook and all those things that people have direct access to you to tell you what basically tell you about yourself, which scared me initially, but actually everybody's been really nice so far.
Good thing or bad thing?
At the moment it's been great, but not for everybody. Heavenly had a bad experience, so she came off Twitter straight away, and one of the girls in my band. So, but for me it's been, so far, touch wood, it's been good. I've actually really enjoyed it.
Good. Well, that's good news to hear. Well, good luck with the tour and have a lovely evening tonight. Thank you.